Alright guys, welcome to another video. Today we're going to be doing something a little bit different. Maybe going over some of the bikes that are you can buy off of Craigslist and sell for profit. I know a bunch of you guys are into selling and flipping bikes and whatnot, and you guys don't really know where to begin. So we're going to go through the whole process here and figure it out together. So I started doing this about, I think when I was like maybe 20, started flipping bikes. What you want to do is go on Craigslist. It's the first step, sign up with an account or whatever. You're going to want to start out with like maybe, if you've got like 300 saved up, that should be good enough. Usually you're going to start out with like a moped. So in the summer when the mopeds are hot, you want to go buy like a moped for cheap. Usually buy like a Honda or Yamaha moped. That it's worth some value. For cheap, you can probably pick one up, like a Honda, like this one over here. This is a great example, actually. Like this one I picked up for, I think, $225 right here. And it's worth at least, it's between 500 and 4, like 400 and 500 when all working and everything. The trick is to have a title with it. You want a title. This guy has a title. You don't want it to run. That's what you want. So that's why it would be sold cheap. You find the moped. You see it's up for like $225. Doesn't run very well. Bogs down or whatever. That's the best. So then you can just take it home, fix it, do like a carb clean on it, whatnot, clean off the gas tank, all that easy stuff, and then you sell it for $450, $500. That's an instant profit of what, $200? It's easy. And you can sell these within a couple days, easily. So like every week you pick up like five, you could probably sell all every single one of them, the five, within the next week. Guarantee it. So what, five times two? Five times $200,000 profit in 2 weeks off of mopeds only. And that's only getting five of them and fixing five within a week in 2 weeks. So, I mean, that's $3,000 a month if you can do the math, which isn't too bad, picking up five mopeds a week. And they're everywhere on Craigslist in the summer. So that's one tip. And make sure they have a title. Otherwise, I think it's illegal to do. But, yeah. Next would be dirt bikes. Dirt bikes are pretty tricky sometimes. I'd say the best brand for selling would be Honda. Honda by far. If you find a CR250, those are worth a ton. CR125s are usually worth a lot, as I have both of them here with me. I usually always buy the CR125s and the CR250s if they are around $1,000 to $1,200. No matter what. And obviously, running condition and whatnot. But yeah, I always buy the Hondas. They've never let me down, really. For smaller bikes, you can buy the CR80s. But typically, those don't sell for more than $1,000. So if you can find one for like $700, you could probably maybe get $900 for it. Or maybe if you can maybe find one for $600, and then you can get like $900, make $300 profit. But those usually take a while to sell. If you want to buy like a CR125 or a CR250, look for ones around the $800 to $1,000 range, and then you can sell them for big money, like $1,600, $1,700, $1,800, $2,000 sometimes for the 250s, and sometimes the 125s go for $1,300 to $1,600 depending on where you are in the location and if people want them bad enough. But I always stick with the Hondas for flipping if I do flip bikes like that. Especially dirt bikes. The next dirt bike I would flip, I'd say the worst bike to flip is probably a Yamaha. Yamahas are typically, I shouldn't say all Yamahas. I should say that the 125s are pretty rough to flip. You can find a 125 Yamaha for like $900 and maybe flip it for like $1,000. I mean, that's all you can do. 250s, on the other hand, if you can find one for like $1,000, you can easily flip it. Same with like the CR250s for 1500, 1600, 13. It's like 13 to 1600. But yeah, then KTMs are probably pretty bad to flip. I mean, they're already kind of expensive to begin with, and nobody really wants to spend that much money. Suzuki's are great to flip. I love the Suzuki RM125s, RM250s. Those things are awesome, actually, which is surprising. Not many people really own Suzukis, I don't think, and I haven't seen an RM125 for sale in a while. But yeah, RMs are always good. Love the RMs. And then for motorcycles, flipping, always stick with like the vintage stuff. I mean, you really can't flip newer stuff anymore. Everyone knows the value on Natty Guide and whatnot, and they always look that up and go off of that, which is already priced low to begin with. So always stick with the older bikes, like a DT250, which is right here, but obviously not this kind. Like, you want the mint kind, like over here. And if you can find them for cheap with titles, that is the best bet you're gonna have. Like this one, we found for $500, I think, or $600 with title. Works, runs, perfect, everything. You can go on eBay right now, type in 1973 Yamaha DT250. A couple lists of motorcycles will come up. They're all selling for like $27, $23, $17. So instant profit of $1,000 right here, for example. Which is insane. Like, four bikes a month, that's $4,000. I mean, yeah, it's insane how much money you can make doing it. But, yeah. And then, obviously, like, the older stuff like this, you want titles for. Otherwise, they're worth nothing without the title. So always get the title with it. I picked up this one. My grandpa gave me this for $400. And if you have a title for it, they're going to be worth, like, $800. Without the title, they're going to be worth, like, $200. So that's the deal with those. Four-wheelers are pretty tricky to flip. Wouldn't recommend flipping four-wheelers, really. Unless you really know what you're doing. I really don't know too much about four-wheelers. That's not my specialty. I'd say my specialty is the bikes, which I've got pretty much down the prices for them. So I kind of know what everything's worth, which is nice. You scroll through Craigslist, and I mean, you can instantly pick out if it's a good deal or not, which is helpful. And it just takes practice knowing when they're a good deal and when they're not, and being able to sell them and stuff. And then for selling, just take really good pictures. For example, don't take the picture in your garage like this of the bike. If you want to post on Craigslist, don't take it like that, because you can see all this clutter around everywhere. Just makes it look crappy. Makes the bike look crappy. Go outside to a nice area where nothing's in the way, with a nice background. Take it like right here, or on the sidewalk, or anything like that. Just don't take it in your garage next to other bikes like this. Like, if I was to take it right here, probably wouldn't even sell it. But, yeah, that's another tip. Don't take a dumb picture. I see a lot of blurry ones, too. Make sure it's a good picture. Otherwise, you have to redo everything, and it's just a pain. So take the picture. Write a description that's very good, I would say. Like, the upgrades on the bikes. Let's see here. If anything's wrong with the bike, it runs good, if there's good compression, because that's typically like whatever you would ask, add that in the description, so people don't have to ask like 1,000 questions when they first text you or call you to find out about your bike. Always put the tire tread, like it's 80% or whatever. That's always helpful. I always take up close-ups of the motor, like in here, because that kind of tells if it's leaking or not, and that gives them like a good description of the motor and whatnot. What else do I do? Keep it pretty short, though. You don't want it too long. And if you're going to flip a bike, I probably, if you're planning to rebuild it and flip it, it's probably not the best idea. Rebuilding a bike is usually around, like, the full thing is like a $600-$700 for like bottom end, top end. So if you're planning on doing that, you're gonna have to find a bike for like $500, because nobody wants to spend over $2,000 on a 125 anymore. So even if it's like a brand new rebuild, unless it's like mint, but I just can't. You'll never get your money back out of it. So don't get your hopes up if you're trying to rebuild it and then sell it for more than it's actually worth. You can probably still only sell it for what it's worth. Another tip for Craigslist would be, let's see, when you buy it from someone, don't post it like right after you buy it from them, because people see that it's like the same bike, and then they're like, oh, the same bike is up for even more, and they get all mad and they flag your posts. That's another thing I learned. So wait a couple days before or after buying it so the person can delete their previous posts, so you don't have two of the same bike popping up. And it looks like it's like a scam. So yeah, that's another thing. So rundown, just a quick recap. If you're starting out with little money, go for the mopeds. If you know how to work on them mechanically, go for the mopeds. You can find one for like $200, flip it, quick make the 500. Then you can move on to the dirt bikes, find a dirt bike, like a 125 that's kind of not running that great for like $500. Flip that, make $1,000. So you're up to $1,000. What can you buy with $1,000? You can maybe buy a CR250 if you find one, if you're lucky. Oh, what are you going to do with that? Doesn't run that great, just fix it up a little bit with no money, and you can probably sell it for $17. So now you're up to $17, and what are you going to buy? Huh. And you just keep on doing that, and eventually you're going to end up with like $30,000 in your pocket, and then you can buy bigger bikes and more expensive stuff like RD400s that are worth $3,000, flip them for like $4,000, $1,000 each bike. That's kind of how it works. The more money you have, the more money you can spend, the more money you can flip. So I hope this tutorial kind of helped you. If you guys have any questions about flipping bikes or how much stuff is worth, just leave a comment below or Instagram me at 2_vintage_. So it's a great thing to get into, good hobby, and it gets you working on bikes, learning about bikes. And if you guys are interested in a career in engineering, it does help a lot with that. There's a lot of problems in engineering, and like involving pistons, rods, cylinders, all that stuff, like the heat, thermal expansion, all that stuff. It's all engineering, and it does help you a lot if you already know about the bikes and the motors and how motors work and whatnot. So that little background information can get you far in life. So yeah, wrap up the video. We're at 10 minutes or whatever, so should be good. All right, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing. Until next time, we are out.